السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله
وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صفيه وخليله بعثه الله هاديا ومبشرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا فبلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين. أما بعد أيها الإخوة المؤمنون أيتها الأخوات المؤمنات، سؤال يسأل: هل هناك فرق بين الإسلام وبين الإيمان؟ فإن كان هناك فرق فما هو هذا الفرق؟ الحقيقة يا أخواننا أن هناك فرق بين الإسلام والإيمان إذا وردا معا في سياق واحد. أما إذا ورد الإسلام مفردا فمعناه الدين بكامل أركانه. إذا قلت أنا مسلم أي أنا أتبع الدين الإسلامي، فالإسلام هنا معناه الدين إذا ورد مفردا. إن الدين عند الله الإسلام، ومن يبتغي غير الإسلام دينا فلا يقبل منه. فورود اللفظ مفردا يعطي معنى واحد وهو الدين بتشريعاته ومبادئه وقوانينه. وإذا ورد الإيمان مفردا إنما المؤمنون قد أفلح المؤمنون الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون، إذا أفرد أيضا الإيمان فقد يطلق أيضا على الإسلام. ولكن إذا جاء في سياق واحد اختلف المعنى. لذلك عندما جاء جبريل عليه السلام إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فجلس وسأله عن الإسلام فأجابه عن الإسلام، ثم سأله عن الإيمان فأجابه عن الإيمان، ثم سأله عن الإحسان. هذا دليل على أن الإسلام غير الإيمان وغير الإسلام إن وردا في سياق واحد. فالإسلام هنا الأعمال الظاهرة والإيمان الأعمال الباطنة. الإسلام الاستسلام الظاهر، والإيمان الاستسلام الباطن. لذلك عندما شرح الله لنا قصة الأعراب قال: وقالت الأعراب آمنا، قل لم تؤمنوا ولكن قولوا أسلمنا ولما يدخل الإيمان في قلوبكم. فالإيمان إذا ورد في سياق واحد هو الثمرة من الإسلام، لأن هذه الحركات التي يقوم بها الإنسان ليست هي المقصود بذاتها. ليس المقصود الصلاة من هذه الحركات التي تؤديها، وليس المقصود أن تصوم، وليس المقصود أن تحج هذه الحركات التي تؤديها، إنما المقصود من هذه الحركات ثمرة الإيمان، لأن الإيمان هو المرتبة الأعلى والمرتبة العليا التي يريدها الله سبحانه وتعالى منا نحن معشر المسلمين. Dear brothers and sisters, a question being asked: what is the difference between Islam and Iman? Are we a Muslim or are we a mu'min? And what is the difference between Islam and Iman? The ulama in the book of Aqidah, book of Creed, they talked about that. And they said, if Islam come by itself, it was narrated by itself, mean the religion. وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا as a deen, as a religion, and the religion has all component. So faith, ibadat, whatever, it is in Islam. Islam as a religion. When the word come by itself, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَا يُقْبَلَ مِنْ إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Deen, the only accepted deen, the only accepted religion is Islam. When Islam comes as in this format, then mean the whole religion, whatever inside this religion, faith, ibadat, all of it. But when two words come together in a sentence or in a statement, when the two words come together, Islam and Iman, come together in a statement, then each word has different meaning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was describing al-A'rab. They said, al-A'rab, this Bedouin, they said, we are a believer. Allah told them, you are not a believer yet. You are only Muslim. And the Iman did not enter your heart yet. So when the two words come together, it carry different meanings. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the Al-Lut, the family of Lut. He described them in the beginning in Mu'mineen, and he described them then in Muslimin. Why? Look at the verse. قال فما خطبكم أيها المرسلون قالوا إنا أرسلنا إلى قوم مجرمين لنرسل عليهم حجارة من طين مسومة عند ربك للمسرفين فأخرجنا من كان فيها من المؤمنين أخرجنا من كان فيها من المؤمنين فما وجدنا فيها غير بيت من المسلمين أخرجنا منها المؤمنين ولكن البيت كان من المسلمين. لماذا؟ لأن في البيت كانت امرأة لوط، كانت تظهر the wife of Lot. She used to proclaim she's a Muslim, and but inside she's not a Muslim. The Iman is not entering her heart. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described those who went out with Lot, he said, the only people who went out with Lot are the believers. But we only found one bayt, one home of Muslim. And that is the house of Lot alayhi salam. But he described his house as a Muslim and not as a believer, because those who went out with Lot with his from his home are believers. Those who were as a home in the description, it was a Muslim, because his wife was there. She used to proclaim, she used to say that I'm Muslim in front of her husband, yet she was not a believer. And then that every believer is Muslim, but not every Muslim is a believer. So you can be a Muslim in a time of people who are hypocrites, in the time of the Prophet ﷺ. He used to call them Muslims, but they do not have faith in their hearts. But they're called, they proclaim they're Muslim. So you take it from them. But they are Muslim in word, but the heart did not enter their hearts. So here, this hypocrisy, or it can be sign of the weakness of faith. You might have Islam, but you might not have strong Iman. You're Muslim, but you have weak in Iman. And this is not easy what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. When we pray, Allah wants us to strengthen our Iman. The result of the praying is not the actual movement you're doing. When you fast, Allah does not want you to get hungry. This is not the benefit of the fast, is to get hungry. This does not need it. Allah does not need our hunger. Allah does not need our thirst. Allah wants us to go uplift ourselves to the second level. The second level is the level of believers. So the Bedouin, when they said, we are believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you are not a believer yet. You are a Muslim. So you have to get to the second level of faith. And the second question, why is this happening to us today? Why we are in this situation? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لِلْكَافِرِينَ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ سَبِيلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, why we are in this situation? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah will not leave the power over the believers to non-believers. When we see ourselves today hopeless, useless, powerless, there is a problem. And look at this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لِلْكَافِرِينَ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ سَبِيلًا. مُؤْمِنِينَ. He did not say Muslimin. Because we are Muslimin, we still need to uplift ourselves. So we might have Islam, but we need to dig for Iman. We need to look for Iman. Our brothers and sisters, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you victory, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَكَانَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نَصْرُ مَنْ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَكَانَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نَصْرُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. كَانَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نَصْرُ مَنْ. وَكَانَ حَقًّا عَلَى اللَّهِ. وكان حقا علينا. الله سبحانه وتعالى جعله حق على نفسه أن ينصر المؤمن ولكن لا ينصر المسلم. ليس حقا على الله أن ينصر المسلم, حق على الله أن ينصر المؤمن. فعندما تكون غير منصور, when there is no victory, when there is loss on all levels of life, in economy, in education, when there is loss in everything, that means there is a problem there. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised to give victory in all aspects of life to the believers, not to the Muslims. So we still have to, maybe we might come and pray, we might fast, we might this, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the end of the day, 2 million people in Hajj this year, and 3 million maybe next year, and 4 million the year after. What's the problem? And they're all doing dua. We come every Friday to here, but why we are there? Why? Why is nothing changing? While the issue in Syria is getting worse, in Libya, in Iraq, in Kashmir, and many more, and you can see that those who are for non-Muslims, they have over power over Muslims, taking their land, taking their wealth, and you can see it. And it's not something hidden, that even the kids know it. So while we are in this weakened level, and when the others, they are in the upper hand level, because we still need, we still think we are okay. We come there and pray to rak'ah and that's it. As we are giving a favor to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we come to Friday and that's it. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. And when you call to the people to stand for the massacre that's happening in Quebec, we don't see much people. We're not there. When you ask people to develop their communication with their community, with their organization, we don't see anyone there. We call for many activities, nobody's there. And very important activities. That as we only say that we are Muslim, we come to pray Jumu'ah and we come in Taraweeh, and that's all. This is what is that? And we're gonna enter Jannah with this 2 rak'ah we're doing, and we're giving favor to Allah. We can't. The Ummah is gonna stay like this. We cannot uplift ourselves to the level that Allah Subhanahu wa Taala will want give us victory in our homes to raise our kids properly. The person telling me that My kids is not listening to me. My wife is going against my wishes. And I see that everything's blocked in my life. And this is in a Muslim's life, you can see it. Today in a Muslim life. So brothers and sisters, this is something serious. This is something serious we need, that if we're only going to keep this level of Islam, and this level of Islam is not sure, that if you have really heart in Iman in the heart or not, or weak Iman, if you have weak Iman or no Iman at all, both problematic. Weak Iman is problematic, and no Iman at all, only you're coming only to demonstrate some riyah or some action of showing off, then this is also problematic. And Ummah cannot be uplifted with this sign of backward understanding to Islam. We need to be believers, because the fruits, the goal of Islam, it is to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمْ If you want to be in the upper level, look at this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. Don't be sad. And don't be weak. وَأَنْتُمْ الْأَعْلَوْنَ. Allah will give you the highest level in this dunya. وَأَنْتُمْ الْأَعْلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُسْلِمِينَ. إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Don't get them مُسْلِمِينَ. The issue is not with these Muslims. Yes, I am Muslim as my religion is a Muslim. If I'm saying the word in general, I am a Muslim. Because Islam is the deen. But what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from me? Allah wants me to be a believer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants me to be a believer. And to be a believer, this is high status. When you are there, then everything around you, it will be changed. It's changed. That العلو في الأرض تثبيت for believers. And how can you become believer? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described in his book, how you can be a believer? He said, التائبون الحامدون التائبون العابدون الحامدون السائحون الراكعون الساجدون الأميرون بالمعروف والناهون عن المنكر والحافظون لحدود الله وبشر المؤمنين. 11 characters that you have to have them included to be among the believers. First of it, التائبون, those who repent a lot to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you 3 sins, it's wrong. Those who repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continuously and insistently, that you always repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah loves those who do mistakes and repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swear by the soul of Lawwama. La uqsimu biyawm al-qiyamah wa la uqsimu bin-nafs al-lawwama. This soul, that when you do something, you repent directly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say, oh Allah, I have done this. Because this is what Yusuf did. This is what Ibrahim did. This is what Yunus in the Batnul Hud did. So brothers and sisters, the first character, Ta'ibun. The second character, Abidun. That the established worship is not the only worship of praying to Rak'ah on Fridays. This is not what the Islam wants from us. Want us to be, when we call for a rally, to defend your brothers and sisters in Myanmar, to defend your brothers and sisters in Al-Aqsa, you have to be there. You have to have this care of your ummah, of belonging to the ummah. If you sit home and you only come for Friday and say, I don't know if I did my job. This is the obligation I have done. Alhamdulillah, I prayed to Jum'ah. No, I'm now giving Allah favor. And this community, I came and I prayed, and I'm parking a long way. So what do you want more than that? It's enough. I am doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told me to do. This is not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to uplift ourselves to the levels of Iman. And this level is not easy to reach. It needs work and hard work. to succeed in your school, to succeed in your university, you cannot lay down in your home and watch TV. You cannot sit not doing anything. If you want to obtain high status in university, if you want to obtain good marks in your school, you need to work hard to get it. You need to work hard to obtain it. And if you want the high status of Iman, and that is mean the high status in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's side, when you go to Jannah inshaAllah, into Firdaus al-A'la inshaAllah, you cannot say, Allah, I prayed to rak'ah, I came to Taraweeh, and you know I have done enough. This is not enough. Your life has to be, your life, 24 hours, submitting, worshipping, because worship is not only salah. And that quick salah, and we wanted to get rid of it. So brothers and sisters, let us adjust ourselves. Let us build this character within ourselves. Let us be with this 11 characters of the believers, that to uplift ourselves to be in the level of the true believers. We don't want to be like the Arab. We don't want to be like the Arab. قالت العرب أمنا قل لم تؤمنوا. You're still not a believer. So brothers and sisters, this is not an easy task. And we need to teach our kids the difference between Islam and Iman. Iman is the target. Iman is the six pillars of our deen. Iman is the six pillars of our deen. Six pillars of our deen: to believe in Allah, messengers, angels, books, the day of judgment, and each and the qada and qadr, khayrihi wa sharrihi min Allah. Each pillars, we can write a book. What does it mean to believe in Allah? Mean not your wealth first, not your money first. Allah is first. You put everything behind and you focus on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructs you to do. This is the real belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. Umar ibn al-Khattab, he was late for Asr prayer because of his garden. Asr prayer, Jama'ah. I'm not talking about skip Asr prayer. I'm talking he was late for Jama'ah. He did not pray Asr with the Jama'ah. He considered this as a huge sin, and he said, I was away because of my garden. I witness you, this garden is Allah's sake. I give it away, and it's so expensive. Would anyone give his business away? Would anyone give his home away? Would anyone give his business away for the sake of Allah because he is not praying Asr in congregation? That this is not the issue of Asr in congregation. The issue of how Umar al-Khattab is really format himself to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he was true believer. He uplifted himself to put Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. And his order first, his love first. When we do that, we are true believers. وَكَانَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نَصْرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَكَانَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نَصْرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَأَنْتُمْ الْأَعْلَوْنَا إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. أقول قولي هذا، أستغفر الله. أستغفرك ربي لا أحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. عباد الله، اعلموا أن الله قد أمركم بأمر عظيم، بدأ به بنفسه، وسل به على ملائكة عرشه، وسلس به على عباده الصالحين. فقال عز من قائل: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي الكريم وعلى من سار بهديه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم اعن الخلفاء الاربعه ابي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، واجعلنا اللهم في ذريتهم يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون الا من اتى الله بقلب سليم. Dear brothers and sisters, all the sahaba and the tabi'in, they worked very hard day and night. Wallahi, they worked very hard, very, very hard day and nights, that you and I became a Muslim today. We cannot lay down. If we lay down, the voice of those who are spreading hate against Islam and Muslims, their voice tomorrow, it will be more than it is today. Every month, they have rally at the city hall, calling to hate Muslims and Islam. They are few in numbers now, but if they kept doing it and they increase their voice, then tomorrow you might not find me doing khutbah here, and you will not be allowed to pray even. The voice of hate, I was told, after the incident of Quebec, the Imam himself saying that we faced many hate crimes after it. One of the brothers who was the president of one organization, his car put on fire. Many masjid were attacked after the incidents in Quebec. The hate level is increasing in 200% in the few years. And this is gonna continue if we're gonna stay like this. And you know what? Do your job. Okay, Imam, go to the rally. Imam, go and vote. Imam, do whatever you want. Whatever we hear, that's it. We come to Jum'ah, we pray to Raka'ah, and that's it. No, we need you, I need you, I can't do it by myself. Huh? When I see my community is not there, I feel shit. Why we are not here? This is a serious issue. This has happened on the soil of Canada. 6 brothers killed, 19 injured, 5 in critical situation. It might happen here in our Islamic center. Why we're not there? And I want to understand why we're not there. To keep me there and my community is not there, this is, it cannot keep doing it, brothers and sisters. Whenever we call for something, please act. If your voice is not being heard, the other voice will be heard. If the voice of peace, if the voice of harmony you carry in your deen, with the word of salam, the voice of hate will be spread. And you would not imagine how fast it's gonna be spreading. You could not imagine. Because the brothers and sisters who used to live in Bosnia, and in Kosovo, in Albania, they were living in peaceful manner, and they said nothing will happen to them. Yet, their masjid were burned, and they were killed, their women were raped, in a very, very shameful time in the 20 centuries. And you saw it, and I saw it, and it might happen anywhere. So we need to stand. When we call for any action, brothers and sisters, this is a serious issue. When we call for anything, write to your MP, write. When we call you to go to the rally, you can stand there. Your presence only standing there, it means a lot. Called? I know it's called. I was called also. But be there. Your presence means a lot. When you call for any rally, you might say, you know, what's the rally will do? So this is shaitan. What's the rally will do? Everything you do, what's I'm gonna do? I'm not gonna go. This is shaitan. Shaitan wants you to stay and not saying anything or don't act by any positive manner and leave it. And if we leave it, the voice of hate will jump. Brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, our kids, they have hijab today. And they go to the buses, and they go to schools. Tomorrow we don't know. If this stereotype still going on, so you're not gonna be able to maybe to call your brother or your son or your daughter a Muslim name, give him a Muslim name. We might not be able even to say salam alaikum in front of others. Do I make you scary, to scared? This is not my job to make you scared, but to make you aware that the voice of hate outside and been working day and night was too much money. Many times my khutbah, it's on YouTube, that they're listening to my khutbah even, and they're trying to make fitna out of it. Doctors, Munir khutbah, they're trying to make fitna out of it. They're working day and night to spread the voice of hate. You have to be there. you have to act very fast. And everyone, whenever we tell you something, please take it serious and act upon it. Every week we have programs. Every week we have something, please act upon it. اللهم برحمتك نحدث وعليك نتكل لا تكلنا لأنفسنا طرفة عين نأخذ بناصيتنا إلى الخير اللهم اجعلنا من المسلمين المؤمنين اللهم اجعلنا من المسلمين المؤمنين ولا تجعلنا من المسلمين الذين لم يدخل الإيمان في قلوبهم ولا تجعلنا من المسلمين الذين لم يدخل الإيمان في قلوبهم اللهم ادخل الإيمان في قلوبنا اللهم اجعلنا من العالمين العاملين اللهم اجعلنا من العالمين العاملين اللهم اجعلنا من المسلمين الذين يعبدونك حق عبادتك ومن المؤمنين الذين يؤمنون بك حق الإيمان اللهم إنا نسألك ربنا أن ترفع عنا ما نحن فيه اللهم ارفع عنا غضبك اللهم ارفع عنا مقتك إن لم يكن بك علينا غضب فلا نبالي ولكن عافيتك أقرب لنا نعوذ بنور وجهك الذي أشرقت له ظلمات وصلح عليه أمر الدنيا والآخرة من أن ينزل علينا سخطك أو أن يحل علينا غضبك لك العتبى حتى ترضى ولا حول ولا قوة
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على السلام حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر